the relationship between the two of them off screen. You see them, they're just very affectionate with each other, very caring with each other. So that's lovely and kind of infuses the relationship between Jamie and Claire.
It looks like the chemistry was just awesome between you two. Is that instantaneous, or do you have to go through a process to get it there? How does that work?
They fed us a lot of alcohol and put us in a room for a while. And
no, I think I think from the first time that I met Sam, he had obviously been cast quite a while before I was. And so when I walked into that audition room to test, he was just the greatest guy. And like the two of us just started chatting away to each other while the producers were talking about something else. And it was just very instantaneous that we became very good friends. We had one day in London, we went for a big walk and we sort of talked a little bit about the characters, but just about our lives. And it just sort of started.
I think it just feels like trust. You know, I trust Katrina, and I think it's fun.
He's being modest. Sam's the greatest guy, and I think that's what people are really like. That's why women go crazy about him, because really see what a good guy, and that shines through always. And he's not just the good-looking hunk. No, not at 6 a.m.
Not at 6 a.m. Certainly not.
Ugh, my breath. Okay.
Sorry.
Something I said.
Coffee's getting cold.
Fucking Katrina's getting cold. Fuck your coffee.
Sorry.
Oh, sorry. That's...
Was that real skin?
Yeah.
Shit, sorry.
Press. I got it. Don't you worry.
You told it to me.
What?
Blood of my blood and bone of my bone. There's a plane coming over.
What are they going to love about my performance?
You share a question. We're going to be digging deep here. No, Katrina, I mean, Katrina, we knew from the second that she came into test and she left the room, we all knew she was the one. She had to play.
Aww.
She had to play Claire Randall, and she does. She absolutely walks on set and she controls the whole thing with humour and skill, and she's an absolute joy to work with.
And she's a good actress.
She's okay.
Yeah, it's the best I can get.
I
mean, Sam is incredible. We have so much fun on set, but I think, you know, the thing that Sam brings, which is so necessary to this role, is there's this beautiful symbiosis, this beautiful mix of strength and vulnerability, which I think is sort of really crucial to Jamie. And you know, he's just such a sweetheart.
Aww. Don't believe everything she said.
How do you guys feel about the reaction to the wedding episode?
What reaction? Yeah, I mean, what is the reaction to the wedding episode? Do people like it?
I think that's what they thought, right? They thought he was hot. Yeah. I knew he was hot, though, so, you know, I already knew that.
You're pretty hot, too.
No, it felt really great. I mean, you know, there's been such a nice stuff written about how that episode was, and you know, I think we all really worked hard to make it as real and give it the space that, you know, these two people, their love could like really develop, and you know, that it wasn't instantaneous, you know, sex, and that they could just get over the nervousness and get through the night, and I'm really glad that, you know, people responded well to it, right?
Jamie got laid three times, that's pretty
good. Jamie got laid three times. Have you guys actually watched the episode? Did you watch it? Sometimes actors don't watch. Is it weird?
Is it weird to say that we watched it together? With a bottle of wine? Probably. A couple of bottles of wine, actually, yeah. Yeah, we were like, we've got to watch this.
So. We were, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And we kind
That's
of
weird,
enjoyed
but
it.
Anyway,
but we were quite drunk.
Everybody wants to know what that was like to shoot that scene. I mean, did you have to throw a few back before camera started rolling? Yeah,
there may have been a hip flask involved.
Yeah,
right?
It's actually in the top drawer of her dresser.
Yeah.
And whenever, you know, there was a little break, may have had a little stiff one.
But no, I think, you know, we had built up. Did you really say that?
No.
Oh, I know what 69 is.
Claire, what have you done to yourself?
Well, I'd imagine... What have I done to myself?
You shaved your punani.
I know, but what's the line?
Diana Gabaldon told me, you have not lived until you heard Sam Ewan say honeypot.
So we're waiting.
Go on.
think you'll have to watch the show. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Got to watch the show.
I mean, if you hear it now, it won't have the same impact.
Oh, we'll love it.
Well, but you're probably not as indignant. But you, I know you're...
It depends how you eat your honeypot as well, doesn't it? Like, your fingers or your tongue. I don't know. Yeah, like, I mean, then you get sticky then.
Good night,
everybody.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Please.
Ridiculous human being.
No potatoes today.
How would a nobleman such as yourself come to such?
It's only one thing. One possibility.
I bring you the blessing and thanks. I took him by surprise completely.
I'll be back before lunch. I promise I'll be... Sorry.
Right. Fucking...
What?
Sasa.
He lives in a brothel. I don't know what the rest of that life.
There's something I haven't done. I completely fucked up the life.
Oh well.
Who's holding my pen?
You and I haven't spent any time in a house for many a month.
I would have returned sooner, but I only recently discovered.
Go get my medical case. It's in the... Now we're taking it from your life.
Thank you.
Oh dear. I proved to her as much as she did to me. Sorry, I can't remember. Clear!
Oh shit.
Did I not give you long enough?
The first on screen kiss. See, Jamie and Claire didn't kiss for a long time.
Was it the wedding? It would have been the wedding episode.
It might be the wedding.
Yeah, that was...
It might be it.
The wedding episode.
Yes!
I say I'm not... I don't have such a bad memory after all.
Yeah, because they didn't. Yeah.
So, yeah, our first kiss was also our first a lot of things.
Yeah.
We just... Straight in the deep end.
Yeah, together I think they're really strong. And we had a scene the other day, and I don't want to give away too much, but we made love, I think, without making love, if you know what I mean. And that's what we were trying to do. Does that make sense?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Like phone sex or something? What?
There are no phones.
Texts, lots of texts.
Oh, right, sorry.
Emojis.
But between the two of you, as people, you're getting to know each other better. As Sam and Katrina, have you found that you've learned something, even though you know each other so well?
I have learned he's a ridiculous human being.
Well, I think you knew that earlier, though, no?
That's true.
But recently, no, have you learned anything about each other that might be surprising to others? I think it's just our friendship is like we've been working so closely alongside each other now for 6 years, and it is true, like we sort of have a second hand with each other, and I just know exactly what he's thinking so many times. And
yeah, I think that's it. We know each other, and I can tell, you know, if she's upset or if you've got a sticking point, or if you're. I'm just gonna go.
Do you want some whiskey?
You want a whiskey?
He needs a whiskey, please. Stat, man.
Here's to making love without making love.
Okay, I can take it. Oh, he's not finished. Okay. Okay, I'll let you finish, because the next question is for you. You may need another. Thank you. If Sam, if season 5 Jamie could go back through the stones to tell season 1 Jamie...
He can't go through the stones.
Okay. All right. This is hypothetical. But if he could go and go back in time to season 1 Jamie, what would he warn him about in season 5?
Don't go near her. Your life is going to be a mess.
You love it.
I mean, she's just turns his world upside down. And I think every time Jamie looks at her, I think he sees his own demise. In that he knows he.
Are we on the same show?
It's his power, right? No. He knows that he would do anything for her. He would die for her, and I think that's it.
That's the reason Outlander exists, though, isn't it?
It is.
I fucked up that line, I'm sorry.
Oh, fuck, he's...
Fuck, fuck,
fuck.
Fuck.
What the fuck?
What the fuck is wrong with you?
God, I could fucking...
Arms holding my bin.
Again. It's great. It's great that we were able to get along that well, but we're not together. And I'm sorry to break people's hearts, but you know they like to try and I don't know, maybe replicate the Claire and Jamie story.
Right,
but I
right.
think it would be difficult for us to work together and
yeah,
be together.
Try. Yes. Yes. Yes.
I'll have what she's having. Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry.
Are you Harry or Sally?
I'm Harry. Because you're Sally.
Oh, yeah.
What is the most romantic thing that Claire's done for Jamie?
Giving him a child.
I mean, aww.
It's pretty really romantic, sweet. Isn't it?
What's the most romantic thing Jamie's done for Claire?
He's given her a pearl necklace.
He's given her... He's drawn her a lovely bath. I think that's pretty romantic.
Jamie's given her a lot of things. I think the pearl necklace, it was his mother's pearl necklace. He's very romantic. He's always giving her things.
Yes. But most of all, he's given her his love.
His love.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite Gaelic word?
Mon grai. Grai is my love.
Fraser seeing Jamie after 20 years.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, all right, yeah. See you then.
Yeah, what's up? See you, bye. I made a mistake. Take me back.
Who would you make it Facebook official with? Jamie. Who would you take to see 50 Shades of Grey? That would definitely have to be Jamie. It might inspire him to... something. Maybe he doesn't need the inspiration. I don't know.
Any chance? Was this bite from a monkey?
If Katrina messes up a take on set, then she...
laughs.
Who a messes lot. Up the most takes?
Katrina.
And is it just breaking?
She breaks well, everything else.
Well, you know, sometimes Sam has very funny facial expressions.
That's not true, but...
She's just the best giggler, but yeah, she doesn't try to hide it. It's basically
my problem. I have a terrible poker face. He's great. I can see him, like, he'll have this little tiny movement of the eye where I know that he finds something really funny, but he's really good at keeping it together. Me, on the other hand, I just fall apart.
It's just because I'm dead inside.
You've got Wi-Fi on set. She's on always on Wi-Fi. She's got Wi-Fi in the car. She's got Wi-Fi in the makeup trailer. I don't need it. She's always, and she's like,
that
oh.
Is
and
such
she's
a
always buying
of...
stuff. It's so true. She's even her driver has got her own Wi-Fi. And she also buys so many pieces of artwork and clothing. She spends all her money online. It's dangerous to people.
That's so not true.
She spends all her money online.
Jamie, look at her. Eye contact. With her, not me. You each say one positive word about the other.
Beautiful.
Sexy.
What is it?
Assassinate. Je suis prêt.
Uh-oh. You can stop now. You can stop. No, I just know.
I like that one. Can we do that?
Sorry,
I'm going to do that again.
Come on. Oh. Come here.
All right, Sam, I have a similar question for you. Now, I guess the best way to put it, let's say Jamie had a Tinder account.
Oh, sorry. Tinder camp, did you
say? A Tinder account, and in your bio it said, absentee father, certainly a murderer, probably doesn't shower that much. I mean, what's left? I mean, is there anything else? I mean, you would swipe left like there's no tomorrow. So, and yet, so many women just find him absolutely irresistible. What is it about him that makes all of us want him so much?
Is that kind of hard for Sam to answer about himself or his character?
Maybe it's the picture, I don't know. Did he do a cock shot? I'm not sure. A what? I think.
Did you get it?
He said maybe it was.
He didn't say it.
I think it's probably down to Diana Gabaldon's character. You know, I think it. You know. I've never been on Tinder. No, I think, you know, he's such a great character, and he's.
Can I just ask how many people are on Tinder right now Googling Sam Heughan?
This is for the original Sassanax, for Katrina, wherever she is.
Is this a gift for us? That's so sweet!
For Katrina, but there will be plenty more to come. She is the Sassanax.
I would do anything for you. She's amazing. But, she can also drink a hell of a lot. It's incredible.
Thanks for the feels, guys.
Aww. What would I sacrifice for love? I guess everything.
What would you sacrifice, Katrina?
Everything.
Thanks very much.
That was fun.
Yeah, man, we're just hanging. Life's good, man. Me and my cat just hanging out. I'm sad.
You got a cat, man. You got a cat.
Fuck, I'm so sorry, Andre.
Touched you, vibrating stone.
Okay, I want to ask you, 2 years ago today, what were you doing? Do you know the significance? 2 years ago, July 9th.
2 years ago, was it? Did I get cast 2 years ago?
You got cast 2 years ago. And how?
Your anniversary? Yeah. Aw, congratulations, babe.
Happy.
Jamaica, make sure you don't smoke too much weed. Huh? Oh dear.
Hi there. How you doing?
Hello. And Sam? Sam?
Keep going.
Sam!
Visit Scotland.
I need a louder action. I can't hear a fucking thing.
Did I fuck that up? I did tonight, for fuck's sake.
Fuck, you just fucked that tape.
Don't
to
you
me
ever
there,
fucking stop our tape.
I was
again.
So in it.
Where are all these damn initials? I can't see a fucking thing.
I fucked that up. Let's start again.
Sam down. Sam up.
Outlander studio tour. It's obviously a very big studio. And I don't know how to stop.
can be a nightmare for others. I still can't believe this Roger left her alone. Aye. Well.
He's been on the whiskey again then, I
What
think.
About... So what?
I'll be back before lunch. I promise I'll be... Sorry.
Seeing how scared Sam was of the maggots, that was quite fun. It was also fun kind of showing them in his face.
Oh, that's so gross. Oh, God, they're coming out of his leg. God, that's so disgusting. Oh, God.
All right, let's have a go. All right, Bill, thanks.
I don't want to do Outlander anymore.
Look at that, oh, this bastard.
Finishing up here.
We just act like a married couple because we act as a married couple all the time, so it's
bickering, bickering, or real life.
My hands are shaking from holding back from you. All of the silence and patience, pining and desperately waiting. My hands are shaking from all this. Say my name and
I love Katrina, she's fantastic.
If I call up a militia, he'll be expected to fight, being fit and of age.
Can't you keep him out of it?
The regulators are disorganized. No way, Perpov. I just saw you creeping in there and I thought, this is brilliant. I wasn't prepared for that.
Hey guys, why don't we go this way?
Claire. Jamie and Claire are very strong together, always have been. As they've got older, that bond has really strengthened.
I love the confidence that Diana had, first of all, in her books, but also our writers have in allowing them to become a solid foundation and not feel that they need the drama of, will they, won't they, to continue to keep people interested.
As much as it shouldn't be labelled as a romance, that love story is central to the whole core of it.
You know, I think Sam and Katrina did such a great job with those scenes, and you just felt once again and are reminded of this great, amazing love story between these two.
Sam and I have such a shorthand with each other and such a great friendship as well that we get to bring that into this relationship. But there's still things that surprise me about Claire and Jamie, and there's still things that surprise me about Sam Hewen all the time.
Oh, thank God.
They're stronger than ever. There's still a great chemistry between them, and the core of everything that Jamie does is Claire.
The beauty of this is examining what a real marriage looks like, and, you know, it's not like they agree on everything. This couple truly, truly love each other, and they know that they've found their soulmates in each other, and that's enough. And I think that that's a beautiful thing for people to watch and for people to aspire to.
As long as we both shall live.